Hello friends, welcome to online computer classes. This is a video about operating system, and today we are going to discuss about the scheduling algorithms and especially one, the fcfs, first come first serve. These are the contents which I am going to cover in this video. Now let's start. First is process state. A process can be in one of the several states. It can be in the ready state, new state, running state, waiting state, or terminated state. The operating system keeps track of process state by maintaining a queue of PCBs for each state. PCBs, process control blocks of each state. Operating system keeps track according to that. The ready queue contains PCBs of processes that are waiting to be assigned to the CPU. The scheduling problem is the need to share the CPU between multiple processes in the ready queue. There can be 1, 2 or thousands of processes in the ready queue, and the CPU need to be shared between them. The operating system needs to decide which process gets the CPU next. Once the process is selected, operating system needs to do some work to get the process running on the CPU. How the scheduling works? The scheduler is responsible for choosing a process from the ready queue. This is the work of the scheduler. The scheduling algorithm implemented determines how process selection is done. The scheduler hands the selected process off to the dispatcher, which gives the process control of the CPU. But when does the operating system make scheduling decisions? In what conditions it makes a decision? Operating system makes the decision of scheduling when a process is terminated or when a process switches from running to waiting state. Scheduling decisions are made when an interrupt occurs only in a preemptive system. There are two types of systems, preemptive and non-preemptive. But in a preemptive system, the operating system has to decide which scheduling, which process will get the scheduler, will get the CPU when an interrupt occurs. But how is the CPU shared? In non-preemptive scheduling, the scheduler must wait for the running process to voluntarily relinquish the CPU process, either by terminates or blocks. And preemptive scheduling, the operating system can force a running process to give up control of the CPU, allowing the scheduler to pick another process. Now, what are the scheduling goals? The scheduling goal is one of the most important goals is maximum throughput and resource utilization. This is the most important goal of any scheduling algorithm. Maximum throughput and resource utilization. For this, it needs to overlap the CPU and IO bursts, IO activities. And the next important goal of scheduling is minimum response time, minimum waiting time, and minimum turnaround time. And it shares the CPU in a fair way. May be difficult to meet all these goals sometimes. Need to make trade-offs. And what is CPU and IO burst? Typically process execution pattern. It is the execution pattern. Sometimes the process uses the CPU for a while, which is called CPU burst, and then it does the IO operation, which is called IO burst. CPU bound processes perform IO operations infrequently and tend to have long CPU bursts. And IO bound processes spend less time doing computation and tend to have short CPU bursts. Scheduling algorithms. CPU scheduling deals with the problem of deciding which of the processes in the ready queue is to be allocated the CPU. There are different types of scheduling algorithms available. First is first come first serve, FCFS scheduling, shortest job first, and priority scheduling, round robin scheduling, multi-level queue scheduling, multi-level feedback queue scheduling. Today we are going to discuss about FCFS. Let's discuss this. FCFS, first come, first serve scheduling. FCFS is the simplest of all scheduling algorithms. The key concept of algorithm is allocated the CPU in the order in which the processes arrive. That is, the process that requests the CPU first is allocated the CPU first. The implementation of FCFS is managed with a FIFO queue, first in first out queue. When a process enters the ready queue, its PCP is linked onto the tail of the queue. When the CPU is free, it is allocated to the process at the head of the queue. The running process is then removed from the queue. The code for FCFS scheduling is simple to write and understand. FCFS scheduling is non-preemptive scheduling. Once the CPU has been given to the process, that process keeps the CPU until it releases the CPU, either by terminating or by requesting IO devices. FCFS scheduling is suitable for batch operating system. The average waiting time under FCFS is often quite long, especially if request of short CPU burst waits behind the long ones. FCFS is not suitable for time sharing systems, where it is important that each user should get the CPU for an equal amount of arrival time. Now look at the example how FCFS works. There are four processes given, P1, P2, P3 and P4. The arrival time of all the processes is zero. They have different burst time. Now look how it works. Now what is the average waiting time? The average waiting time for process P1 is zero because it starts when it arrives. Then the average time of P2 is 7 because it needs to wait until P1 completes and releases the CPU because it is non-preemptive scheduling algorithm. So P2 has to wait till 7. Same as P3 has to wait till P1 and P2 completes and it will get the CPU and after 11 seconds. So it has the waiting time of 11. Same as the P4 has the waiting time of 13 seconds. So the average waiting time is 7.75 seconds for FCFS. The average response time is also same in this algorithm because they have the zero arrival time. They don't have the different waiting in different arrivals time. So the average time is equal to the response time of the algorithm. Now look at the Gantt chart. P1 starts as soon as it arrives and gets the CPU. Then P2 gets the CPU after P1 completes. Then P3 gets the CPU after P4, P1 and P2 complete. Then P4 gets the CPU after P1 completes. So this is an example of FCFS. I hope you get understand. Now what are the scheduling goals? The scheduling goal is one of the most important goal is maximum throughput and resource utilization. This is the most important goal of any scheduling algorithm. Maximum throughput and resource utilization. For this, it needs to overlap the CPU and IO bursts. IO activities. And the next important goal of scheduling is minimum response time. So that's all for today. I hope you like the video, you like the lecture. Do subscribe the channel and you can also visit our website for more details. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.